Realize Kali Kali.
Of an art greater than that of a father for his son. That is the kind of relationship shared by West Indies cricketer Kevin Sinclair and his grandfather Carlton Sinclair. The Sinclair duo recently spoke about their bond, and Carlton spoke about how significant that bond aided in Kevin's journey to the West Indies team.
To tell you the truth, since he was around 8 years, he was the smallest in the set. Most of these boys are the even better than he. But he hold on for his grandfather, he ain't losing. The rest of them, who never the pressure, gonna have to run. Because he didn't ordinary. Although he did make Guyana and the 15 and 17, some exercise were put upon Yala. From a very young age, I could have seen it in him. You know, he had this thing in him, and well, he there with me all the time because I had a whole set of boys them. And he there wrong. And this same ground here, I could remember much. When I send them boys up early because they make President 11. And I say, you're going to come in. But if you make so much runs, I'm going to give you so much money. And if you take so much wicket, you're going to get a raise again, we got a restaurant. And by the time I, within half hour when I come, when I meet them by a side, where is the score? Them by the score, Kevin ripping them by a part. That they think he takes 7 wicket for 3 runs, bowl Rosal for 13. And then when he go for bat, I say, well, we only get about another half hour more, because you got to make the 100 in. We must have to something, so you get to go to the ball and do your thing. And he start to beat the ball, and then he make 100 not out and a call in. Because them other boys, they want back to. Was 180 something, he and, what is by name?
B.R.E.
We used to call him Lil Tess.
Meanwhile, Kevin spoke about his experience in the West Indies team, and he also spoke about his aspirations, where he's aiming to work hard on his all-round game.
It was a special feeling, me being in the squad and being among all the experienced players. Well, the first day I was a bit nervous because I didn't know what it's like until in terms of the preparation before you go into a game. So I watched on the first day and see what I got to do before a game or whatever, right? And I groove in from there. Bravo and Pollard and the senior guys was behind me telling me it's just a normal game, but it can cause for a lot of consistency. So they was behind me, motivating me, you know, in the fourth, moving in the first game. So I was grateful for that experience, you know, sharing that dressing room with them and gaining experience from them. And, you know, they boost me into my first game and I did fairly well. So, yeah. Basically, I'm looking to cement my spot in the team and cement a place in the team. I know that won't come easy. I need to work on my all-round game very, very much more harder because in terms of staying and being consistent at a level, you have to be consistent in all three areas. So I'm looking to improve my batting mostly because my bowling gets well left my batting. So I'm just looking to polish up on that area moving forward.
He also reflected on his journey with his grandfather, Carlton.
Well, basically, started when I was small. I was in the power pack in the team. I used to run water jolly, you know what I mean, and do my thing until I get a break in the team. His motivation, he used to tell me he's going to be in a restaurant later when I do good. So he used to look as though as $1 million for me, you know what I mean. I get in a half hour. So whenever any cricket game, he's telling me, if I do could be going to a restaurant later. And I used to do it regularly. When I came and played this ground the first time, I was the captain. He sent me up and he tell me, if I do good and get this amount of money or whatever. And by the time he come, we done bowl out the team for 30. So that was the turning point there. And even the next game, I said, Carlo, Well, I call it Carlo, you meet the name Carlton. I eventually get a name. I said, Carlo, you're betting again? He said, no, you ain't betting, you won't broke me. So, yeah, he used to be motivating in terms of monetary and tell me if I do good and your incentive. So that was it. So even when I do good, he just vexed me and cost me a thing. But that was nothing to me. But I used to vex, but I used to take it because I know every morning he used to train me. And I have to train me before a game, so it's indeed you can vex when I fail and how I fail too. So yeah, so all in all, he was behind me whether I fail or do good.